Cleveland and its suburbs are seeing construction projects pop up all the time, either on cleared land or in historical buildings that need a facelift. One project in Lakewood is trying to add some new attractions without stepping on what's already there. So in this News 5 original, we take a trip over to Birdtown to learn about the Nest.
If you're telling the story of this community,
the building's over 100 years old. It was, you know, kind of, the records go back to 1918.
Lakewood's old BiRite Building in the Birdtown neighborhood is a big chapter. Jim Makito bought one of the largest buildings around in 2019 and plans to start turning it into an entertainment space with a coffee shop, hair salon, and some offices in the next few weeks. He's done it once before with Forest City Shuffleboard over in Ohio City.
But it'd be similar in terms of Forest City, in terms of great for events, parties, leagues, just get-togethers, gatherings.
One big piece of the project is adding to the Birdtown neighborhood without changing it. Brian Curran is Makito's business partner.
But there's people in this Birdtown pocket that are super passionate about Birdtown, right? There's kind of a reason why it has its own name.
People like Ralph and Mary Puno.
I just like to see everything occupied and usable.
Who converted an old bank down the street into their home.
Birdtown was always little tiny mom and pop. So in a way, it's keeping in with that spirit.
Stephen Mika and Dave Willett run STEM Handmade Soaps out of a small storefront nearby.
It's been small business after small business that's just kind of like built upon each other.
They're excited about the new neighbor, especially after weathering a tough year of COVID precautions.
It's becoming more of a destination, and our traffic count continues to increase year after year.
And that plays into Jim's plan to create the Nest. He says since the building is so big and has so many uses, somebody could get a cup of coffee on the ground floor before going to their haircut on the third floor, and they could stop at Stephen and Dave's shop down the street before they leave.
It's something that can kind of extend trips to the Birdtown neighborhood.
I think it's just going to be a perfect complement. Right now, we're far from having too much, and I think that'll help us be just enough for the community.
Taking a building that stood for one century and using it to write Birdtown's tale into the next.
There's a book that's unfinished, and kind of from now until the end of time, people will kind of keep adding their own stories to it.
Jim says he expects construction to start in April. He expects to have at least some of the building up and running over the course of 2021.
I love how you say